Hi, I'm Dr. R. Santosh. I'm a consultant endocrinologist at the Phillip Nagar Hyderabad branch of Magna Centers for Obesity, Diabetes and Endocrinology. Today I'll be speaking about work-life balance and how a poor work-life balance leads to us developing diabetes at an earlier age. Now, doing well in academics, getting a very good job, getting a very good pay, and improving our status in society as such seems to play a major role or aim in what we are doing on a daily basis nowadays. Now, the time that we spend with our family seems to be going down day by day. The time that we are spending exercising or concentrating on doing something that is improving our health is almost nil or negligible. The time pursuing our hobbies and recreations is going down. Spirituality, giving back to society is almost zero. In pursuing better academics, better job, better pay, we tend to exercise very less, we tend to eat very irregularly, and the stress hormone levels in our body, they seem to be hitting new highs every day. Now, what happens when we do all these things is the pancreas glands tends to get tired and tired and tired, and we tend to develop diabetes at a much earlier age. At the same time, if we are able to relax by doing something that will help us enjoy, for example, pursuing our hobbies or spending time with our family, the stress hormone levels will be low, and also the insulin that is being produced from the pancreas tends to work better, and the tendency for developing diabetes at an earlier age will not be there. So it's very important that we spend enough time in doing all the other activities that don't build up our stress hormone levels and prevent diabetes in the future. Therefore, work-life balance is a very important topic, and everybody should sit and introspect as to how much time they are giving to their academics and job and how much time they are giving to the other activities in life. Thank you.